that. Oh, and oh. La Vista, Nebraska. So there you go. And this is their Barrel Age Reserve Series, Black Betty Imperial Stout, Asian whiskey barrels, a bottle conditioned. There we go. And again, I don't think I have my can. Bottle. Do I have a bottle of this? I thought I brought it in because I had it outside. I'm pretty sure that I don't have a damn bottle opener. Thought I did though. Who knows? Who cares? Whatever. No bottle opener. No big deal. I don't know if I have to. I had a bottle opener right here. Huh. The joy of having children. The joys of having children. And being really crazy when you get on a podcast and get really drunk. Let me see for a second. I swear I got a bottle there. I brought it in, and I have no absolute idea where I put it. So, hey, fun times. Can't find the bottle opener that I was using, so I'll have to use this bottle opener, which I've never used before. But it's still a bottle opener, so still work. It'll work. Listening just to some Dark Throne right now, relaxing, having a good time. There you go. And here it is. Oh, it smells really good. There we go. Label out, folks. Label out. Let's get this in the glass. Really looks nice. Very copper tonality to the beer while I'm pouring it, of course, but it pours really, really rich, dark, just a ruby of a caramel hue at the pinnacle of the glass there. Nice tight bubbles, alcohol legs really forming well from that 10.6% alcohol by volume, but really silky smooth head on this one, rolling up, watching the proteins stick to the side of the glass really nice, indicative of a nice little viscous body. Very nice indeed. Not trying to stick as far as lacing goes, but there is legs and legs and legs upon alcohol. By the way, that was a gut hook bottle opening. I just pull as hard as you could and pop the top. But you know, you must improvise in stressful situations like this. So there we go. What's up, Brother Craig? Oh, if you're free tonight, I'm off, so we can shoot the shit. Okay, let's get an aroma on the Black Betty. Bam, bam, bam. Wow, that is glorious. There's a hint of something that reminds me of like a dark cherry and raisin mixing in there, but a lot of bright caramel, peppery whiskey. Vanilla, walnut husk. A little bit of a leather smokiness too. So that leather smokiness is coming just as about the same level as a little bit of that cherries coming out too. Well, absolutely beautiful. Baker's chocolate. That beautiful nuttiness, as I said, that walnut husk, kind of nuttiness quality. Roasty toasty, of course, a little bit of brown bread in there too. This thing smells amazing. Again, it was only $11, so 11 plus. It's close to 12 bucks of Bloom Brew. They just got it in. Nice 16 ounce glass, bottle rather. This smells fantastic. 10.6, can't talk, I'm so excited. 10.6 alcohol by volume. Let's get into this one and cheers. Very pillowy, very smooth, very silky going down. No real burn to speak of. There's just a little twinge out here from the 10.6% alcohol by volume. It has a nice, it's a bit thin. All right? Did you expect that from me? You should have. It's a bit thin, but it's tapering that low side of a full body, so that richness is still there. Nice pillowiness. Kids are arguing in the other room. Gotta love that. There's roasty, toasty tones, little brown bread tonalities. You have that bright caramel from that whiskey quality. You have the oakiness, you have the smoke, you have the char. You get a little bit of a raisin or a cherry in there too, in that back note. Mixing in again with a little bit of a leather quality. Really nice. However, because there's that however, it's the beer is trying to complement the whiskey instead of the whiskey trying to complement the beer. Right now, this is very whiskey forward. So that's the major player in this beer. But if you like that, you're in for a treat. Right at the back end, that's when you get the nuances of roasty toasty. You get the nuances of baker's chocolate. You get the nuances of a little bit of dark chocolate too, way in the background, mixing with that nice earthy tonality. Maybe just the faintest hint of a copper coin, way in the back, mixing with all that dark chocolate too. But it's very nice. Not the most robust, not the most biggest beer, not the biggest beer I've ever had. 10.6 alcohol by volume though. It is drinking amazingly smooth. It has a nice little complexity to it. I wish the base beer was a little bit bolder to kind of go toe to toe with the barrel aging process. But again, as I said, it's very nice. You definitely, if you like a very nice whiskey forward barrel aged beer, the whiskey is shining in this. And the beer is there to complement the whiskey instead of, you know, more along the lines of the whiskey complementing the beer. Yeah, I think I've said what I need to say about the beer. It's pretty damn good. I like that little bit of a soft, subtle cherry tone coming through with a little bit of leather in the back of it, kind of very broadening its horizon so it doesn't have that same kind of complexity as a regular bourbon barrel aged beer would have. This has something a little different coming through and giving it its own little unique twist. Again, it's a little bit more whiskey forward than I'd like. It's a bit thin overall in the body, but when you do barrel aged beers, it will take the body of the beer down. It's a natural thing that happens during the barrel aging process. So the base of this would have been pretty nice indeed, nice thick full body, and it would have had a nice a lot of like chocolate and stuff coming to it. The chocolate's died off in the barrel aging process, but you do get nuances of that. I'm just saying, this whiskey is very prevalent, so be prepared for that. But if you like that, then enjoy. Drinking Alula Crunkles from Terrapin. Can't do the barrel aged stuff. Well, if you can't do the barrel aged stuff, definitely keep away from this one, sure. But cheers, Cole. Thank you for commenting. Definitely stay away from the barrel aged stuff if you can't do this beer. There are different ones out there where it's more low key and stuff, easier to acclimate yourself to it. But this is pop you in the face with some whiskey. So make sure that you're prepared for those. I definitely, if you want a nice, big, robust beer, especially from the Terrapin, check out their Wake and Bake. It's a really, really nice Imperial Stout. It has the coffee, it's got the chocolate, it's got everything you want. I don't know if they do a barrel-aged version, but if they do, I definitely want to check that out. And the nice thing is, I bought another one, just in case. So that's always fun. But anyway, thanks for everybody. I have 6 viewers, which is crazy. Good times reminds me of the old days back when I used to stream all the time on YouTube. Anyway, this has been Paul from PA Brew News. Cheers to everyone watching. The guys, Craig and Cole, for commenting. This has been Paul from PA Brew News. I'm going to give this one an 8.5. 8.5 out of 10. If the beer was a little bit more blended, a little more cohesive with age, that will happen. And if the beer was a little thicker, a little bit more bombastic, as they were with the chocolates, the robust notes from the actual beer itself and not just all the barrel, I would have gave it a little higher score. But 8.5 is definitely a nice beer. This is a nice score. This is definitely a nice beer. Give it a go. Let some sit in your barrel house, your fucking, I don't know what the hell I'm trying to say, your cellar, your dungeon, the place where you store the bodies. Let it age for a bit and watch this beer come to full fruition. And let me know what you think. Thoughts and opinions. This has been Paul from PA Brews. Cheers. Bye-bye. Hey.